If Republicans ever actually get their act together, elect a speaker, and finally get to inaugurate everybody into Congress, their plans for this coming year are actually pretty terrible. Because one of the first orders of business that Republicans have is their plan to gut the IRS funding that was increased with the Inflation Reduction Act. They made it very clear that they have their own legislation called the Family and Small Business Taxpayer Protection Act, which would strip all of that new funding away from the IRS. And the reason they're doing that, of course, is to protect themselves, but more importantly, to protect their donors. Because this extra money given to the IRS to hire enforcement agents, to hire lawyers, to hire more people to just go and do audits, was directed at the wealthiest people in this country. You know, the tax cheats, the ones who find these loopholes that may or may not be legal, the folks who might be hiding millions of dollars in offshore bank accounts. The IRS has been ignoring them for years by design because Republicans slashed the funding so much they couldn't afford to do audits on the super wealthy, which is why the lower class, people making under $24,000 a year, were more likely to be audited than those making more than $1 million a year. Because you can go through an audit of somebody making 24 grand a year in about an hour. It takes weeks to months to do one for somebody making more than $1 million a year. That's the difference here. And in order to fix that discrepancy and, of course, recoup some of the money the IRS is losing, in the Inflation Reduction Act, we increased the funding for the IRS. We're going to let you do the things that you need to do. And Republicans were pissed at the time, and so one of their first orders of business is going to be to strip the IRS of that funding. However, silver lining here, they're probably not going to be able to do that because it's never going to pass in the Senate. And that brings us to the second order of business, right? And this one doesn't have to go through the Senate. This is absolutely something that the Republican Party can do. They're going to, and we know this because they've announced it, change the rules and effectively kneecap the Office of Congressional Ethics, which, if you're not familiar with the Office of Congressional Ethics, it is in fact the body, the independent body, that investigates members of Congress when they break the law. So, gee, I wonder why the Republicans don't want the law enforcement agency they have to answer to be able to function properly. Gee, that's a real head scratcher, isn't it? So what they want to do is they want to put term limits on the people serving on that Office of Congressional Ethics panel, which would effectively mean that all but one of the Democrats on the panel would immediately be ousted. So you'd have one Democrat, all the rest would be Republicans, and they would make it to where the agency could not hire any new staffers 30 days after a new Congress is sworn in. So if a new Congress were to be sworn in on January 3rd, under these new rules, that Office of Congressional Ethics for the next 2 years couldn't hire anybody past February 3rd. So even if staffers quit, you can't replace them. And yes, that does happen. People leave, people find new jobs. So what we would see each year, each cycle of Congress, is that office getting smaller and smaller with fewer people able to actually do their jobs. That's what Republicans want. And the big reason, of course, is because they've got some investigations coming up in Republicans, those who tried to push the fake elector scheme, and of course, George Santos himself. But if Republicans have their way, that office will not be able to conduct those investigations because they'll be starved of the means to do it.
This is Hattie. Hattie wants to know why you have not subscribed to our channel. You obviously like our videos, so do us a favor and subscribe.